These images were generated using a text prompt, and today I'm going to show you how to integrate text-to-image generation into our custom WhatsApp chatbot. If you haven't watched the previous video where we built the core chatbot, I highly recommend checking it out first to familiarize yourself with the codebase. We'll be using Stable Diffusion from StabilityAI for the image generation. And before you start worrying about costs, when you sign up, you receive 100 free credits, which is equivalent to generating around 500 images to explore the service without spending a dime. Let's head over to StabilityAI platform, platform.stability.ai. Under the API reference section, there's an open API specification that we'll download and import into Postman. This specification will guide us in interacting with the API. Go to import, select the file you just downloaded, and choose the Open API 3.0 with Postman collection option. Once imported, the API documentation is added to our Postman collections. We'll now explore how to generate images from text prompts using the API. Click on the version 1, select generation, and then text to image. We'll need an API key for authentication, which you can get by creating an account at dreamstudio.ai. It's also a platform powered by StabilityAI, the makers of the Stable Diffusion model we are using in this tutorial. If you don't have an account, sign up and log in. Under profile, go to API keys and create a new one. Copy this key and paste it into the auth tab in Postman as a variable for our collection. To make things simple, let's remove any extra configurations like style presets from the request body. We just want to focus on the text prompt. Let's try a puppy in the clouds cinematic. If you signed up with a personal account, remember to uncheck the organization header. The last step is selecting the Stable Diffusion model. I'll be using Stable Diffusion XL version 1. Feel free to experiment with others. Now click send. You'll notice the response contains a base64 encoded string instead of an image, but we want to see the actual image, right? Here's a cool trick. Postman allows us to visualize the response. Click on scripts and select post response. Postman uses handlebars templating, so with a little JavaScript and handlebars magic, we can convert the base64 string to a visual image using an image tag similar to HTML. Then we take the response from pm.response. When we send a request, the visualize tab will display the image instead of the base64 string. You'll see the image of our adorable puppy in the clouds displayed in the visualize tab. Now that we've tested the API, let's integrate this functionality into our WhatsApp chatbot so that users can transform their text prompts into stunning images. I'm using WebStorm as my IDE, but feel free to use any you prefer. Following best practices, we'll work on a new branch for this feature. To keep the main project safe, use git checkout -b fit/text-to-image-generation. The -b tells git to create a new branch. Remember the intelligent chatbot that we built in the previous video. We'll use the same modular approach by creating a module for text-to-image generation with NestG module stability. We are using the Nest CLI. This automatically registers the new module in our app module. Then we'll create a service for this module with NestG service stability AI. The business logic in this case is text to image generation. The stability AI API requires a post request for image generation. So we'll import the HTTP service from NestJS Axios and register it in our service constructor. Save the API host, auth token, and engine ID in a configuration JSON object. Let's store the API host and token in our environment file for security, but make sure that you are not committing the environment file to any version management system included in the .gitignore file. Create an asynchronous method called text to image. We'll copy the JSON object from our Postman request, JSON encode it, and replace the static prompt with the dynamic prompt provided by our user. Since we are making a network call, we'll wrap it in a try catch block to ensure the program fails gracefully if there's an error. Specify host and engine ID from the environment file. Then specify the request headers in a config variable for text to image. Copy the post request code we used in our WhatsApp service and paste it here. Instantiate a logger so we can debug any issues that arise. The NestJS logger. If the request fails, return an error message. Since we are using an observable for the post request, we'll use last value from response, which is from RxJS, to get the final response. The module is an ability to generate many images, but for the purpose of this tutorial, we're just generating one. The response is an array of base64 images. We're going to store them in a dedicated folder, which we're going to call generated images. We are looping through each image generated by the model and giving it a unique file name. We are using the current timestamp to ensure that those file names are distinct. We then write the base64 encoded image data to a file in our generated images directory. Lastly, We push the file names of the generated images to our array and return that array. Let's start our server in development mode with npm run start dev. We need to create a generated images folder manually as we'll save our images there. But later on, I'm going to show you how we can automatically create this folder if it doesn't exist, such that when a user makes a request to generate an image, if the folder doesn't exist, it's automatically created. For now, let's copy an image of a puppy and save it in the generated images folder. If we visit localhost 3000/puppy.png in our browser, we should see the image, but instead we get a 404 error saying it doesn't exist, but it's there in the folder. Pause the video and drop your thoughts in the comments about why this might be happening. Ready? Here's the answer. We need to configure NestJS to save static content like images for us to be able to get the images which are in the generated images folder. In our main file, import Nest Express application from NestJS Platform Express, then include the Nest Express application in the Nest Factory and configure it to save static assets using app.use static assets. Then we specify the folder where the static assets are, generated images in our case. Reload the page in your browser and there we have our puppy in the clouds. Now delete the generated images folder as it will be created automatically later on. Back in our Stability AI service, before generating an image from a user's prompt, we automatically create the generated images folder using the FS module. Now, how do we send the images to the user using the WhatsApp Cloud API? Head to the WhatsApp Cloud API Postman collection we imported in the previous video. Go to the API reference, navigate to messages and click on send images by URL. Click the code icon in Postman to get the Node.js equivalent code using Axios. The method is pretty much similar to the way we are sending a normal WhatsApp message. So in the WhatsApp service, copy the send WhatsApp message method and rename it to send image by URL. We change the payload type to image, remove the body and AI response parts, change user input to file name, which is the name of the file we want to send back to the user, the generated file, and update the key labeled text to image. Finally, we'll provide the URL, which is our host server, followed by the file name. In our WhatsApp controller, we'll use a trigger command /imagine to determine whether the user wants to generate an image or have a conversation with our AI assistant that we built in the previous video. If the message contains the trigger word, we'll call text to image generation, providing the user's message with the trigger command removed as the prompt. If the response is an array, it means an image was generated, as the text to image generation method returns an array which contains the file names. In our case, we made it so that it only responds with one, but the API on its own has an ability to generate many images using one prompt, and we'll send it using send image by URL with the user's phone number, file name, and message ID. Since our array contains one file name, we just want the first index. We expose our local environment using grok http 3000, copy the URL and update the webhook callback URL in the developer settings. Verify the webhook, subscribe to the messages field, and you're good to go. Let's test the chatbot. Send a message with the trigger word /imagine and a prompt like dog. The chatbot doesn't respond back with the generated image, but when you look into our generated images folder, you see that there is actually a picture that has been generated using our prompt. To solve this issue, we just need to save the server URL in our environment file, because if you remember, we are sending the link to the image that is hosted on our machine to the WhatsApp service, and this in turn gets sent by WhatsApp when responding back to the prompt. We then reload our application for the change to take effect. Now try a prompt like butterflies on a sunny day, dogs running around, realistic. It's generating, but the bot still isn't sending anything. This is due to the fact that the auto import of modules in my editor mistakenly imported process. Fix that by removing that from the import. And finally, try a prompt like a serene sunset with vibrant colors. The bot responds with a beautiful image. Let's test one more time. A lion in a car. And it works. Finally, we'll delete the generated images folder and prevent it from being sent to our version control system. We exclude the folder in the .gitignore. That wraps up our tutorial. We've successfully integrated text to image generation into our WhatsApp chatbot. Now you can empower your users to create amazing images directly through their conversation.